Stress is important to know because, like a paperclip bent too many times back and forth, if you stress something many times, you get what's called structural fatigue. And structural fatigue too many times over many cycles with too great a stress range results in catastrophic failure. In the case of a ship, that's from the wave loading. So my research is focused on a particularly challenging problem, the monitoring of structural health of ships. And as you probably know, they're over 1,000 feet long, and the locations that we're looking to measure for structural details or deformation are interspersed around the ship and separated by watertight compartments. And what we came up with is the world's first 3D printable strain gauge. SAS is the strain amplification sensor. We call it that because it operates using a series of levers and mechanical system to amplify strain. The SAS provides in real time the stresses that a ship is experiencing. And because of that, we can get a sense of the structural degradation for the construction of ships, and thereby the safety of the vessel at any point in its life cycle. That's one component of the SAS. The other is the SAS is a tool that can be used by not only the crew, but also those who are brought out to rescue the ship to understand the stresses and the forces that are taking place on it. That way they can understand, oh, do we actually need to abandon the ship or should we stay on it? Outside of visually seeing a crack or seeing a really significant, what we call permanent set, so permanent deformation of the outer shell of the ship, this would be the only other indication that they would have. That the structure is in fact beginning to fail. Really, right now, they just rely upon visual indicators because there does not exist a very well rolled out system for structural health monitoring on ships. SAS can be attached to the material with magnets, and SAS is standalone, which means that it doesn't require power or data acquisition cables or system. It's 3D printable, which means that we can also adjust parameters of the sensor for every single sensor that's produced. SAS is almost infinitely tunable, so to speak. So we provide a very efficient tool to gather this data, both for the crew and for the salvors, and thereby we increase the safety and reduce the risk of these situations. 90% of goods by value are moved by ships. So they're operating 24 hours a day to provide us with almost everything that we touch on a daily basis. Currently, there isn't a cost-effective way to monitor the structural health of a vessel. And SAS, although it's not a comprehensive solution, it's a component, and it's moving us in the direction of being able to provide ship owners and operators with structural health monitoring capabilities on their ship and give them a way to acquire the data to make decisions on inspection and repairs that they don't currently have.
What we're trying to do is develop robotic systems that are able to autonomously map ship hulls while they're in port for the specific problem of limpet mines. This is something